Resistance has been after an alien collaborator for some time now, and they finally got a solid lead on their location. They're asking for our help in ensuring the target is dealt with, so we're moving in to secure the area. Neutralize all hostile forces standing in your way. If possible, capture the VIP alive. If all else fails, take him out.
Greetings and welcome back to some more Long War of the Chosen Mod Gem Edition. And apparently we're supposed to take out a VIP, like to dinner.
Target location confirmed. Move to engage. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Weird question from Bradford, but okay.
We're operating in the shadows.
I'm just working here. I'm not making the calls. Okay, VIP is in the building. We do have sealed armor dark event, so depending on what kind of enemies we see, we probably get limited value out of our little what are you again? Technical. At least you can do scouting for us and not find anybody. Okay. Kind of want to check this side of the building. Oh yeah,
I'm on the move.
Our little recon. Can go around that side and not find anything. Fantastic. Maybe there are no enemies on the map.
Let's go. Ich bin da.
Hell yes!
That's just for safety reasons, have you steadied here in the back. I'm gonna be lagging a little bit behind, but that's just the fate of the sniper rifle class. Okay, I think I saw two drones over there.
Alright.
Finder and some other dude.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Through the building, then you don't really have a way of getting out again. So let's okay. Just keep walking across the edge here, yeah? Along the edge. Now the drone comes in from the side. These guys might come in from here. That's all a little bit annoying. On the other hand, though, we could just take out the Pathfinder. Shots on the drone from here. Yeah, it does. There was a second drone here, but nobody has line of sight to that. I think we might just open up here.
They found us! X-ray neutralized.
11 damage crit. Oh, the other guy doesn't even activate because sometimes scatter is weird. You know what? Okay. We're probably activating the second drone here, which is fine, right? We just want to get stuff off the board. No, we're not.
I don't miss often.
Understood.
I'm not sure why those guys are on alert, by the way. I guess because the medic ran back there. Alright. But that's three enemies, well, two enemies that we can actually set on fire. So 4 enemies that are all unarmored and weak to AP grades. Hmm. That's probably a little bit too too ambitious to go for them.
Duh. The fun is in the chase.
Bring up on the high ground. So also, that puts us at 6. This drone 7 if we can actually find it.
Finally. I was worried this was just another bug hunt.
Not a good position now. It means you don't have a shot. Let's I move you weird. You have a shot. Alright, oh.
Target eliminated.
Roger that.
Let's just chill out here. Keep an eye on those guys.
Stay together.
Move up to the roof. Is there a chance for them to come up here, reveal me, or see me and activate? Say no. You there? Alright. We see the snake. I don't know if we're gonna fight next turn, but this lasts for 2 turns, right? Independent tracking, so might as well throw it on there. They're buggering off again. Okay.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Are you telling me that we can just invite him for dinner?
Target asset sighted. Target neutralized.
Reapers are not useful on guerrilla operations. Anyway, snarky comments aside, want to sneak up on these guys and not get ambushed by whatever's left on the map here.
Sure.
Let's just leave you here. I'm not sure.
Got it.
Wanna like you and your shotgun need to be closer, but how do we do this without risking too much here? I'll just let Chef come in here. And you come back.
Understood.
There had better be something good for all this weight.
That might be a shot here, man. Okay.
Try harder and try again.
At least that shut down any yellow alert actions, right? Right. So do I want to clip this thing with the AP grenade? Like the Flame Viper is probably the most dangerous enemy that we're facing here right now. Fairly certain you cannot get any shots on. You get a move. Can totally get a flank there. Could slice that guy. or the Flame Viper. We've got a slice on that sector. We've got a flank shot on it. So I think the Flame Viper is much more dangerous. Let's get a little bit of damage in here with that AP grenade. Hopefully you can finish it off. Could have been a bit more.
All happy?
Guess we had that one covered.
Moving.
Sector will move, it's flanked. It does have some corpses there for some psionic shenanigans. Or it can just double move, that's fine too.
Destroys.
These early laser swords are such a big damage boost here. Stress that enough, how much that is helping the campaign. Also, well, having a bunch of classes that can use that stuff.
Alright. What exactly do you plan on doing with that thing anyway?
Running!
What's that? No.
Okay.
Okay.
Would be two more enemies on the map? Probably. Music, but that's probably just the VIP. It's counting as active.
What's over there?
I didn't pay attention if there was an admin turn.
Yeah.
Then again, does he count as advent? I think he runs away, right? If you get line of sight on him. Let's play it slow.
Sell a copy. Yes.
I'm going in.
You pay attention if there's an advent turn.
Yes. Good for all this weight.
But I'm never sure if alien activity could just mean, yeah, the VIP is doing his thing. Are you gonna run away from me here?
Right.
Menace 1-5, remember, we're here to capture the VIP if possible. Knock him out and bring him in.
Warning.
Status confirmed. Target package in custody.
I hope it's worth it.
I guess I'll take him. We came out here for this.
We did. We did indeed.
Yeah.
No need to ask twice.
All right. Well,
I understand.
Probably be out next turn, not sure about Rebecca. She's like one turn short, unless if everybody here moves out of the way.
All right.
Peek around the side. Like, I wouldn't mind finding two more enemies to kill. But getting out of this flawlessly, it's also not bad. What if you move away?
Got it.
But no.
Come on.
Then we'll all wait.
Don't worry.
Already there.
This is boring.
Get ready.
Would be my missing kill XP.
Okay.
Affirmative.
Commander.
Moving to position.
It's a little bit risky in case that last group is coming in somewhere somehow. And take shots at us. A little bit out in the open.
Could, pick up the pace?
I'll just wait here.
I just hope you're ready.
Even the reinforcements drop out of range here. Oh no, that looks like in range. Ooh, that's a nasty reinforcement pod.
Enemy detected. I'm sorry.
You should see the look on your face.
I've got other plans for you anyway.
Ah. Don't mind me, just making sure we're not bringing any dangerous explosives onto the Sky Ranger.
Now I will show you just how to.
Fire in the hole. That was a lot of scatter for a fire in the hole rocket. Fire in the hole. That puts us at 9 kills. We're leaving.
You were cutting that a little fine.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Good job, everybody.
Think the elders will like this one?
I'm not even sure if I like this one. I'm not even sure what's happening. Why are they suddenly stacking on top of each other in half of the photos? I mean, I guess the other question would be, why not? Why the hell not?
Citizens today for standing up to those who would abandon our values for those of the old world. The remarks followed a moment of silence for peacekeepers slain by XCOM dissidents.
I wondered how the new gear would hold up, Commander. Looks to me like it's working out just fine.
All right. Center mass, because clearly you're not doing enough good damage yet. Our ward. So, here are the choices, and they are all good choices. Lightning reflexes, it's always good, you know, we're not gonna have as many assaults with so many classes around, so someone else with lightning reflexes is a really good pick. Sixth Sense, immunity to multi-target and area attacks, grenades, explosions, flamethrowers, psi bombs. There are a few things that you would expect to be area attacks, but they're still hitting you, so I'm not 100% sold on this yet. Then we've got Premonition. That's the one to change stances without attacking. So, as I understand it, with Wardens at once, right? We could do a dash move, then we get the ebb and flow bonus move, so we could trigger premonition, go into offensive stance, and then actually take a shot after a dashing attack. I'm still not 100% You sure that's actually how it works? Reaction of Intention Khan. Interesting combos. When Warden can melee first, then shoot at point blank range, or prepare a defensive stance ability for an attack. Like, as much as I like lightning reflexes, I think, like, getting in there, especially if pick up impulse later on, might be really nice. I'm a little bit, you know, I do have high combat intelligence, which also translates to a high psionic score. So getting recharge and cycling your psi abilities faster might be interesting. I still think combatives is better. Now let's go let's try premonition and see how that plays. Big Wars is a really good haul. Probably get sold again, but it's a good haul. Sitting on 91 alloys. So that also gave us 22 intel, which, you know, is great. Idle stuff in the Proving Ground. No. How the Proving Ground works. Reduced contact cost. Oh, that's gonna be big. Ah, that's actually really good. So I think the idea was to run this now. Probably with pretty much the same squad we just had. If we can afford it on a willpower basis. Okay, so we had Jet. Still though, there's nothing really to hack on that mission. I think I'll take it. Right, yeah, I'm just looking at it 10 times over, and yeah, it seems all fine. Do we have any PCS? Conditioning, focus, defense? Maybe that focus, if anyone here is really low on will, maybe it's Jet himself, yeah? Maybe on Spana, just to make sure he can stay in missions for now. So I know you want to become a mech, but I actually don't think recons make good mechs. I'm gonna commit to the shooty recon here for a while longer, at least. Sent you on my way.
Sky range.
Menace, ready to deploy.
Next up, we're gonna put our scientist back in here to find more missions now that this one expired, etc. Also fairly close-ish to Hopefully succeeding with this, at that point Liberation 3 starts spawning and we want to find that as soon as possible. So there's two issues at the moment on the world map. Issue one is the big one, we only have two contacted regions, which is not great. Issue two is we do not have any major liberation progress on these contacted regions, which is also not great. The one thing we've going for us, we had like a UFO, a supply rate, a troop column, and we have another supply rate queued up, so that we're removing strength from the world. And we're gaining a bunch of corpses. Like, our finances are good, tech is okay, it's not amazing. We're not ahead of the curve, but we're also not behind. And we have this Vigilance 14 beacon here, pulling in all the strength. This will probably go up to strength 10 easily before we outpace it here. And at that point, I want to be in a position to liberate this. Anyway, long story long. Scan here, find some juicy targets, like, no, not get Edward's attention. By the way, I was kind of confused about the Proving Ground and the mech augmentation. It was just, we had two different ranks, so it took a different amount of time. The fact that you can put people on the mission while they're being augmented is just a bug. It's just a kind of non-fixable thing where you just have to ignore that. Alright, let's take a look at our brand new Helmian. So, the Helmian starts with the canister, which is like the secondary. They have the flamethrower primary weapon, and then they have a canister they can unload through their flamethrower, which is not fire damaged, so you can do something to enemies that are immune to fire. Start with open fire, 10 aim, 10 crit against targets at full health. Fumigate, cleansing chemicals, removing environmental effects from targets, so kind of healing-ish. And the usual mech trooper immunities. And protocol suits. Now, we already know that chemflow suppression is really strong because it's guaranteed to apply burn to all targets in the suppression cone. So I don't see myself ever taking one of those. Formidable is not bad. This gives 15 crit to all targets in the AoE, which also seems good. But no, we're gonna take Chemflow Suppression. And then we have here Mind Control. Prevents hitting unintended targets with your Chemflow. Congratulations. You just can flamethrower everything and you've got friend or foe detecting fire. Seems nuts. Nuts more about taking it. And that then, I didn't even check my abilities down here. Supernova, Evasive, Impulse. Moving Flames, Chemflow Reaction Fire has 20% increased chance to crit. Chemflow Reaction Fire, say? You mean like our two reaction shots we get each turn? Now, one thing I don't know. Do my reaction shots automatically have a chance to crit without picking up Cool Under Pressure? I think so. That's actually something I'm not sure about, because otherwise this is completely useless if we need Cool Under Pressure. So what we're lacking right now, what we had before, was the whole panic on flamethrower attacks, which I don't think you can get at all. Supernova. Interesting. So, yeah, we're gonna probably commit a little bit to the Overwatch. Like, I've never been on Valley of Death, but that just sounds like Killzone. But of course, keep in mind, like with my Overwatch attacks, I have an AoE attack. So if I'm overwatching an enemy pot, I'm basically hitting all enemies in that group twice due to Sentinel. So looking forward to that. Also, so we start off with this Incinerator, which already does 3 to 6 damage, so much more damage than the basic Arsonist weapon. Yeah, we'll see how that shakes out. I'm really looking forward to bringing that mech into a battle soon. Let's spend all our intel on these two boosts. Hit that button just briefly. And this is now vulnerable at 102%, very light. Lib 2 for a combat engineer, which I don't think we've seen yet, with 6 guys. But that will have to wait until next episode. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.